Nearly 100% of the people will experience this eye condition starting in their low to mid 40s. Nearly 100%. You will get presbyopia. Your eyes will fail you. Let's focus in. Presbyopia, the official definition, farsightedness caused by loss of elasticity of the lens of the eye, occurring typically in middle and old age. That's a good definition, and it really is the gradual loss of the eye's ability to focus on near objects. And we get patients nearly daily that come in for this exact reason, this exact symptom. They usually are saying their eyes can't focus on, you know what, here, let's go over here. They'll start saying, hey, I used to be able to look at my phone or book up close, and slowly but surely they've had to push the phone out farther and farther until it gets to a point where their arms aren't long enough to actually see. Small print, close up will become blurry, really tricky to focus on. Transitioning, going back and forth between distance and near objects will take longer to focus on, and you might have to blink or reset your eyes more often. Also, these patients will notice that they have more headaches and eye strain and fatigue when they're using the computer or reading something up close for long periods of time. One other thing that they notice is that they can see things better if it's well lit. If they get a lot of light onto something that they're reading, they can see it better. Like if they go to a restaurant that's dimly lit, if they can finally get the right lighting on the menu, then they can see it better. One other thing that nearsighted people notice is when they're wearing their glasses for distance, they start noticing that things up close are getting tricky, so they'll start to look under or over their glasses because they just prefer to use their natural nearsightedness to see up close. Looking through the glasses, it's actually harder. So what actually causes this? Let me go over to the eye model to show you how this happens. So I want to draw your attention to this guy right here. This is the crystalline lens of the eye. It's right behind the color part of the eye, the iris. And this is the source of everybody's frustration. This is what allows us to transition our focus from distance to near. It's actually a flexible lens. So when the eye muscles flex, it actually bends this lens. Now what stinks is as we age, this continues to grow. Just like the cartilage in our nose and our ears, this continues to add layers every year. And then so eventually it gets to the point where the eye muscles can't bend the lens as much as it used to. And that's where you start pulling things back so that you can see them because this lens can't focus or bend as hard as it used to. Now this is a natural aging process. It's still one of the most disliked things to talk about in the exam room. When you start bringing up bifocals or progressives, it's along the same lines as talking about cataracts. They're swear words in the exam room. And it just so happens, cataracts happen in the same part of the eye, the crystalline lens. So this guy is responsible for both needing reading glasses and bifocals and getting cataracts. This is the guy, the crystalline lens. Frustration. So if everybody experiences this, what are the best treatment options out there? So first step is get an eye exam. Make sure your eyes are healthy and then get your most updated prescription so you know exactly what power you need for close up. Now your first option are readers or cheaters that you can get over the counter at the store, and they're pretty much magnifiers in frames, and they can work great, especially when you're starting out, but there are a few downfalls to that. They don't correct for any astigmatism, and they have the same power in both eyes. So if you have one eye that might want a different power than the other one, they might not work the best, but they are still an option. Prescription reading glasses would definitely be an improvement from that. So with prescription reading glasses, based off the prescription from your eye exam, you can correct for your astigmatism and the individual eyes. There are bifocals or progressives. These are glasses that have both distance and near, or both distance, intermediate, and near prescriptions in there. So if you're someone that has to do a lot of transitioning, so you look at distance and the near and the computer and the distance, you can have one set of glasses that corrects for all of that, and you can just leave it on the whole day. Now there are eye drops that can help you see up close, especially for those people in early presbyopia. It's called Vuity eye drops. There is a lot more to know for this type of eye drop. I did a full video going over everything you need to know. If you're curious, check out that video in the description as well. There are certain eye surgeries that are an option as well. They can do LASIK, they can do monovision, so they can correct one eye for near and have one eye for distance. You can also do lens exchanges, so they can actually take out that crystalline lens and put in an artificial lens that has a multifocal correction in there, or the monovision correction. Still not perfected, but that is an option. Now in the eye surgery world, they call this the holy grail of eye surgeries because nearly everybody experiences presbyopia. When they are able to figure out an eye surgery that could nearly work for everybody, that's gonna be big. The holy grail of eye surgeries. Now let's not forget contact lenses. Contacts are definitely an option. They make multifocal contact lenses where they have distance and near in the contact. Or you have monovision where you have one eye for distance, one eye for near. Pros and cons, either way you go. A lot to learn about them, and it's good to know all the pros and cons. That's why I recommend watching this video next so you can learn all about that. I'm Dr. Neil Guymon, Dr. Eye Guy. Stay focused.